You know, Amanda, snakes get a bad rap.
Yeah, they do. Like in Indiana Jones.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes?
Or Pee-wee's Big Adventure.
Or like snakes on a plane.
Oh, yeah.
I have had it with these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane.
Yeah, but today we're going to change all that because we're playing the most adorable snake game ever. This is Snake Pass.
Or like Anaconda.
I'm not showing a clip from Anaconda.
Show Anaconda.
Not showing a clip
from
Anaconda.
Best.
All right, Amanda, you ready to get snaky?
No, no, not at all.
Yes.
No, I'll pass.
No?
Yeah, no, I'll pass.
All right, see you, everybody. It was nice fun. Hey, welcome to the Dojo. I'm Jeff.
I'm Amanda.
We're playing Snake Pass. I guarantee you, Amanda,
mm-hmm.
that as soon as you see this snake, you will be 100% down with what we're playing.
Dude, I'm already down because of the cute ladybug on the bottom right corner.
Yep.
I'm in.
All right, so let's get this show on the road.
Ooh, can we be the shape?
There's the snake.
Aww. He looks like the snake from Jungle Book. Or...
Ka?
Yeah.
Nah, Ka was all... He had like stoned eyes. He was a stoner.
Or the snake from Robin Hood. Which is the same exact snake. Everything's so shaky.
Whoa, what's going on? Mr.
Hey, listen!
Oh, no. I just enjoy how whimsical this is. Noodle! The snake's name is Noodle.
Noodle, that's fucking adorable.
Noodle! Yo, Noodle! What? We're waking up snake. I didn't think snakes could close their eyes, can't they? Did they lick their eyes? Just That's my snake eye lick noise.
Yeah, that's not a good noise. That's so cute.
Just yesterday.
The ladybug's still there. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
All right. Just yesterday on Facebook or on Imgur, I was looking at, I just did a search for the snack tag and then just like looked at all of the different snack things that were on there.
Snakes are adorable. John will let me get a snake.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. Why not?
I think that's might be a deal breaker, Amanda. It's not a, like.
Uh-oh. Pick up speed by slithering left and right.
You got a serpentine motion. You're a snake. Snurp serpentine.
Wait, can I bundle up like?
Are you donuts? Don't make donuts out of noodles.
Yay!
Yay!
What's the problem with snakes? Snakes are awesome.
I don't know. I mean, he doesn't like them. I just think he doesn't want that to be the pet. He's like a dog person through and through.
Oh, lift your head by holding X. Okay. Let's give it a shot.
This is the best day of my life.
Yay! All right.
Yay!
Snake up those stairs, you snaky son of a snake. You're lower than a snake's belly.
Why are you being so mean to Noodle?
Oh, damn it, Noodle. Get back over here. Hold on. Go for the sky, Noodle. Whee! My roommate used to have a snake. We'd like let him just wander around.
My only thing is I don't want to feed a snake feeder mice.
Oh, man, that's the best part.
Yeah, I've witnessed it, live ones.
Yeah.
Live feeder mice being fed, and it's a little too much for me. Like, so instead of being like, I'm raising a vegan snake, I just won't have a snake and let people who are capable of feeding them properly have them.
A vegan snake.
Well, you know what I mean? Oh, my God. There are people that, like, make their dogs vegan, and it's like, you're killing your dog.
Yeah.
Why have a pet if you can't, like, raise it properly?
It just reminds me of that there was like a Futurama joke with a bunch of like environmentalists or whatever. They're like, we taught this lion to be a vegetarian, and they cut. It's just this like super sick looking lion that coughs.
Aww.
Go up the wall. There you go. I'm missing a thing. Oh no, I got all the things.
There's a gold coin.
Ooh,
right there.
Can I get up on this thing?
Motherfucking gold coin, bro.
Do you think I'm gonna have to like wrap around here? So I got a little. Oh shit. I'm trying. Still working out these snakes. Okay,
he's
wait.
So cute, though.
Hold on. You get around, like, maybe go up. Come on. Just get up
the
on there.
The hummingbird's like, what the fuck are
Noodle.
You doing?
Noodle, get the thing, oh. Noodle.
Now down.
I don't know which way is down. Oh. Yeah, I got a gold coin.
Nice, brah.
Did you just grunt? Fucking snake grunts.
I mean, you did, like, drop him. You plopped him.
All right. What, you needed me to come over here in order? What are you doing? Are you becoming an atom? Oh, okay. We've got all the different candy shapes, I guess.
Delicious.
Okay. What is going on in this world? Okay.
It's so magical.
Is that, do we fix whatever the thing was? Can I go back to...
Did you just open the Stargate?
Oh, it's a Fargate, Amanda. Can I go up the... Wee, Space Snake! Beam me up, Snakey! Oh, man. Oh, are you telling me there were five of those things? Stupendous.
There's too many S's.
I like to think this is what happened to Cobra Commander after G.I. Joe the movie, you know? He went full snake, right?
You never go full snake.
He was a man. Was a man. That was a weird part of that movie.
Yeah.
I mean, like, you know, Cobra Commander's a bad guy, but I don't want to see him get turned into a snake. Have to ride around on roadblock. Something here doesn't feel quite right. We should make sure the gate is okay. Nah. Why? What's the gate?
I'm a snake. Who gives a shit?
I'm going to go and find a nice rock, and then I'm going to lay on top of that rock.
Yeah, in the sun.
Yep. I'm going to hunt.
I'm going to eat one of these fucking bugs that hang out around here. I might eat you, hummingbird.
Who knows? We're friends now, but I'm not really all that hungry. It's just that dumb expression. I was like, so what are some of the best, let's think of some of the best snakes in history, right?
History's greatest snakes. Two?
Yeah.
Yeah, one from Jungle Book and the one from Robin Hood.
Okay.
How about that asp that killed Cleopatra?
Yeah!
I mean, how far back in history do you want to go?
Go asp! You know, just in general, as a species. What about, like, Snake Plissken? He's a pretty good snake, right?
He is a really good snake.
Solid
you know they're going to do...
Whoa, shit.
They're going to do a remake of that?
Escape from New York?
Yeah, and Robert Rodriguez is supposed to be directing
it. No, come on.
All right, now here's my thing about that.
Because okay.
I have a John Carpenter tattoo.
Yeah.
And I plan on having at least a half sleeve of John Carpenter stuff.
Rightio.
So I feel like I'm allowed to have opinions about this.
I think you're allowed to have opinions even if you aren't tattooed. I might have an opinion. I don't have any tattoos.
I refuse to leave.
Hold on. I got to go get a bunch of Dark Souls tattoos right now.
You want Dark Souls tattoos, Jeff. I know for a fact.
I do want Dark Souls tattoos.
But
yeah, go Snake. This game is fun.
But I don't feel like people should already hate on the idea of Rodriguez doing Escape from movie.
Why?
Lest we forget, Escape from LA was not that good of a movie.
So, do you want to know my secret shame?
What's your secret shame?
Yes.
That you like Escape from LA?
Nope.
That
it's
you
close.
Like...
What is that?
You don't like Escape from New York.
Nope. You're getting warmer, though.
That you like girls.
That is my secret shame. I like girls. Sorry, gay ones. No, I'm sorry. I just did a whole video with Matt where I used Butt Pirate. Then we had to talk about that for a while. No, I've never seen Escape from New York.
Oh.
Yeah, which ever let Brian Salisbury know that, because I feel like if he ever found out, he would punch me in the balls.
He's on his way now because he has his...
Oh, God damn it.
His Escape from New York sense was tingling.
He was like, wait a minute. I feel like Jeff is talking about a movie he hasn't seen.
Escape from New York as well as Escape from L.A. The problem with Escape from L.A. is more that it's...
I saw Escape from L.A.
Basically a word-for-word rehash of Escape from New York.
Okay.
Except instead of New York-y stuff, it's all Californian stuff.
California.
Like L.A. Lakers and surfing and the guy looking like Che Guevara seemed really Californian for some reason. Anyway.
All I know is it had that girl from My So-Called Life in it.
Right. She was the president's daughter.
Yeah.
In Thigh Highs.
Wait, was she also the girl that ran away in The Big Lebowski?
No, that was Tara Reid.
Oh. Was that Tara Reid?
Yes.
That wasn't Tara Reid.
How much do you want to bet, Jeff? Because I'm trying to get another tattoo, so if you want to give me some money over this.
No, that's all right. I'll bet you one snake.
It's Tara Reid, I can guarantee it.
Okay.
Do you want me to look it up? I don't even need to look it up.
No, that's all right. That's all right. Anyway, tell me about the... Oh, no, all the keystones are missing, Amanda.
Oh, Jesus. Hummingbird, why don't you fucking do it?
Man, I wish I had like an 8-year-old that I could give this game to.
Aw.
and bring them back to the gate. I mean, this is just like, it's whimsical as fuck.
Yeah, it's super adorable.
I wonder if that one guy...
You can give it to an 8-year-old or Kayla Cromer.
Oh, that's true. That's true. I feel like that one guy who commented on, what was our video? It's got like the most dislikes of any video where it was like somebody that commented and their typing really sounded like they were like a 7-year-old and it was just, stop cursing! That was their whole thing.
They're like, you're using bad words.
And it was
don't
like,
use
yeah,
bad words.
You shouldn't be watching this if you don't like
this
cursing.
This is not for you.
Anyway, let's get back to the topic at hand.
Escape from New York.
Right.
The reason, so Escape from New York feels like an exploitation-y film,
okay.
Almost. Like, it's just, it's not like a sexploitation film. It's not really, it's like a...
Blaxploitation?
It's a little like what Mad Max was.
Okay.
Kind of, it has that kind of feel to it, to me.
Oh, shit. Oh, God
damn. Robert Rodriguez has made...
What was his last movie?
Fuck.
Like, I agree that Robert Rodriguez has... I'm, like, not...
Well, he just makes kind of pulpy, kind of weird movies like that. Okay. So I feel
he
could
God
actually do a fairly legitimate...
Did you like Planet Terror?
I did.
I thought Planet Terror was okay, too.
I didn't love it. I actually like Death Proof more.
Yeah. I like... You know what is... What? Wait. You could lift me up the whole time! You fucker.
Did you just sink down? Oh, no, that's like a slant. Why? Why? At this point, you touching my butt is not helping.
Grab my ass, hummingbird. Grab my snake ass.
Like, can I put you down now?
No! Grab it! My snake ass.
Hold on to it.
Oh, grab it.
Enjoy the ride, hummingbird.
Cup my snaky buttocks.
Man, if I had a nickel for every time somebody told me that.
Oh, girl, your buttocks like a snake.
I'm about to grasp that snaky buttocks.
Do you think this anaconda...
The hummingbird's like, I don't have this kind of strength.
Wow. Do you think this anaconda wants some?
If you got buns, hon.
So here's the thing is, I think that Robert Rodriguez is... I kind of find him deplorable as a human.
Yeah. We can agree on that.
I didn't like Once Upon a Time in Mexico very much.
I liked it a lot.
I mean, like...
But I haven't seen it in a long time, so maybe I'll watch it again and be like, oh, no.
Was that whole thing with Johnny Depp and the...
Was Machete his last movie?
Oh, the second Machete, I bet, was his last movie.
Oh.
Unless, wait, was there, like, another Shark Girl or Lava Girl?
No, there was, like, one of those. There was,
Spy
like...
Spy Kids?
There was, like, 18 million Spy Kids, but those were all before Machete.
Wait, why don't you tell me these things in level one? You mean I can hold on? Hold on. What does L2 says? Get a grip. So I can like squeeze? Wait, hold on. Get a grip. All right, grip. Okay.
Aw.
Snake does not look happy.
He's like, oh, doing a lot of work over here.
What is this grip button supposed to do? Okay, Snake.
Does it make you like push hard against... Oh, he's made a happy face.
Thank you. Hummingbird, now grab my ass.
Grab it.
Don't
look me in the eye when you're grabbing me.
Actually, you know what? I take it back because I thought that Machete, for what it was fine.
I never saw it. Again, that's an exploitation film.
Yeah, it was really stupid. People were like, this movie's so stupid. I'm like, yeah.
It's supposed to be. Isn't that what he's going for?
Come on, Snake.
He's like, Jesus.
Come on, Snake. You got this. Come on. Don't be high right now. Put the bunk. Grab my ass. Grab my ass and pull me up here. Okay,
yeah.
Thank you. I don't know, but in general, I really don't like him. I mean, I think that that's, you know, again. Oh,
oh
shit.
Oh,
ah,
no.
Help
me.
Help me. Hummingbird.
You made him go down with you.
We're all going down. If I don't get out of here, no. Oh, shit. Do I have to go back and get all those things again?
Maybe.
Oh, no. Oh, damn, I do.
Oh, man.
Fucking schmaps.
This is like the Dark Souls of snake games.
Damn it! All right, my favorite game I've ever played. Favorite snake-related game. I need to find out what the...
Besides Snake?
No, fuck Snake. Snake is terrible. Okay, so like I feel like... oh, I see what grip is. You got to grip it. Grip it, rip it. So if you go up like a little ways and then you hold down L2, then he'll like... Nope.
Plummet
okay.
to the ground?
Well, that was some slow ass plummeting. Come on, get the thing, snake. Get it up.
Oh man, he got really close really fast, and then he failed.
If I grab what?
Aw, was that you or the hummingbird?
Okay, so like if I hold down the grip button, he won't like slip off of this thing. That's the whole point of that. But I won't climb either. Okay.
So if I'm not mistaken,
yeah,
there are two kind of snakes that look similar.
Uh-huh.
And they have red, yellow, and black stripes.
True.
And one is poisonous.
Yes.
And one is not poisonous.
Indeed.
Noodles,
yeah,
is poisonous. Because I think it's if
red
touches yellow,
kill a fellow.
Red touches black, you're okay.
That doesn't rhyme. That's a bad.
It's actually red touches black, you're okay, Jack.
Okay. That's also a bad rhyme.
I didn't make it up.
Well, I know. I wasn't like.
But yeah,
I wasn't knocking
sure
you for the bad
just,
snake rhyme.
I'm just.
Damn it, Amanda. I know your job is snake rhyming. You can do better than that.
That's. Those are all my rapping is about snakes because
oh, yeah,
I'm a master at snake rhyme.
That's right.
I spit them snake rhymes.
Spit those hot snake rhymes. Well, you should hear this one she has about asps. The ass on that asp. Back that asp up is what it's called, I believe, if I remember correctly.
My album's not ready to drop. You can't just start telling people.
Yeah. But I thought you released Back That Asp Up as a YouTube single. That was.
It's on my SoundCloud.
Oh, okay. All right.
Now you guys got to look for my SoundCloud.
Wrap around and climb. Thank you. I played this game already. Wrap around and climb. Wrap around and climb. It's a pretty fun little game.
Yeah, this is adorable. I love the way it looks.
That's the second keystone. Keystone light. Ugh, gross.
There's this video that I was obsessed with for a while of this little tiny, tiny pool that had sand in it. Like a little really
soft.
I've seen
it. I was looking at snake videos on Imgur.
Oh my God, it was so cute. Whereas little tiny snake, like it could probably like fit in your hand. Like really
tiny. Oh yeah, it's
tiny.
Very small.
It crawls into the sand and then like just its head pops out, just like
yep,
barely even its head, like its little nose.
And then the person poops it.
And then he crawls a little
and
bit.
And then he
in,
like goes back in.
He's like,
no way, dude. There's still like things to get on this level.
Right. Well, if you fucking fall and you lose all your fucking souls or whatever.
We were just recording the Ringed City a minute ago. I just want the last of the blue things. I don't know about the rest
of them. Are you flying?
Fly, snake, fly! Fly, you snakes.
There was this April Fool's joke a long time ago. I want to say National Geographic did it,
uh-huh,
where they did a special on flying snakes.
Yeah!
And people believed it because it was back when people were dumb.
Because there was no internet. Oh, shit.
Yeah, because people don't believe in fake news stories now, especially because of the internet.
Yeah, definitely not.
We're dangerously close to April Fool's Day.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, yeah, we are. Okay.
Oh, nice. You need one more. It's right there. You're looking right at it.
If I hit this thing, does it count as like a save? Can I get a checkpoint over here? Can a snake get a checkpoint? All up ends. Man, it's this music is just fucking like, I feel like I should be playing Monkey Island or like drinking an island drink. Come on, Snake. You got this.
Do you drink island drinks? Like?
No, Jason Murphy does. They're rum-based.
Added, like,
oh, shit.
I hate rum. He looks nervous. Look at his noodles like, nah.
Oh, God, he doesn't know how to climb, you guys. I don't know that this guy knows how to snake. I think he might be a worm or a centipede man. I don't know.
Centipedes are horrifying.
Yes, they are. Nope. Go
You're
in.
Plummeting. You're
go.
Plummeting.
I'm trying. I'm trying to go around. Help me, you dumb bird. We're just flitting around.
The bird's like, what the fuck are you trying
shit
to do?
There we go.
There you go.
Come on, Noodle. You got this. You got this, buddy. Yeah. Snaking it up.
Nice. Have you ever seen a snake climb a tree?
It's
kind of scary.
Yeah? Why?
Well, a little. I don't know. Just it's weird to see it like move so meticulously.
Yeah.
Were you just dancing around it? What the fuck is this?
It is not super easy to control this snake, Amanda.
Well, it'll like, so a snake will wind itself around the tree.
Yeah.
And then top part will go.
Uh-huh.
And then it'll like coil itself back up. So it's this
I have seen
slow
that. Yeah.
Process.
Ah, shit.
I swear, if you die and we have to start over.
There's not a bottomless pit or anything below me. Oh, shit.
What if you just hit the ground and smush and die?
Bird, grab my ass. Okay, maybe I should try using the thing.
You said grab my ass, and that bird flew the fuck away. He's like, no.
Okay, wait. Okay, so I'm grabbing, and then we're going to go
to. I thought he was going to, like, bite or something.
I'm going to go to this one.
Yeah, and then.
This one. Come on, snake. You got this. I'm wondering what the.
Use your fucking neck powers.
I've always wondered what the, where some of the stuff online, like where the boop snake came from.
I don't know.
Snake!
He was so scared.
It's kind of like I don't know that I really questioned like where the I can has cheeseburger or yeah. like the
like who's
walrus
deciding
bucket.
How all these animals talk.
Right, but with snakes, it's booping on nose.
Yeah,
like I know there's a
I
fair
like they
amount
say
of
heck and yeah. There's somebody that did like a comic strip that was fucking adorable.
Yeah.
I wish I remembered who it was, but yeah, I saw it on.
If you guys have never looked at snake memes, you totally should.
Yeah, they're super cute.
Yeah.
Snakes are adorable.
I like the ones where they had one that I saw that was like a snake where it was like a live action snake and they were like, don't boop. And then somebody hits it on the nose. And then like they did that thing where they put like the kawaii anime eyes and the little embarrassed cheeks
like,
on
yeah,
it.
Yeah, the rosy cheeks.
Yep. Dude, if you guys out there in internet land have never seen those pictures that are just a bunch of sharks, the shark senpai.
Oh, my God.
Do you know
I
what I'm talking about?
Somebody in the comment section is definitely going to be posting all these images.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I don't know who so. You are, but thank you now.
Yeah, those are amazing. It's just
so
like,
cute.
Oh. It just goes to show that as humans, if you just stick some googly eyes on anything, we're like, that's adorable.
It's the cutest thing in the world.
Wind blowing. Check.
My refrigerator used to have googly
uh-oh,
eyes.
What the fuck? What's
no,
going on
dude.
Here?
That
oh my god, the
is
darkness.
Flipping out.
There's some kind of like horrible, terrible hell came to Snake Town.
What was that motherfucking shit? Whatever it was, it removed the keystones and closed the gate.
Oh, you know, from our magical Maya space snake place or wherever we are? What the shit is this place anyway?
That's a good question. That's a proper question.
Thank you. tighten your grip by holding down L2. We've already established that I don't know how to do that, bird. See? You see?
You look so pissed.
Snake is like, God damn it. Fucking bird trying to tell me how to do
bird,
shit.
Motherfucker not even doing anything.
You've got
he
like
fly up here.
Yeah, you got arms and legs and shit. I'm the one who's got a snake all over this place. Doing this shit. Fucking bird. What's up here? I bet there's a thing.
Probably not.
I like the fact that it seems like the people who made this game, they were just like, hey, if we were going to make a snake move on a controller, how would we do that? And then like once they got that, they were like, okay, well, why don't we just make a game out of that? I mean, like, you know, does it need...
Fucking cute.
God damn it.
I'll literally play any game as long as it's got adorable shit or naked ladies, whatever. You guys already know that part.
By the way, somebody did make a comment about how like it's been a while since we played any kind of like booptastic game. Well, trust me, I'm on the lookout. Like,
yeah. Oh no.
Aw,
poor guy.
I need to get that coin. I've been on the lookout. There really haven't been that many. Or if there have been a few, but they haven't been all that interesting. It's been like, oh, this is a CCG where you scratch the cards, like the ladies in the cards, their clothes all come off. And it's like, yeah, but then we'd have to play a CCG. Remember when we played, what was that game, Criminal Girls? Where it was like...
Oh, man, that one didn't work out too well.
No.
There were a couple that I loved, and then there were a couple that I did not love.
I was amazed how well Panty Party did. Because I feel like both you and I were like, dude, fuck this game.
Yeah, we were not like, into it. Get the fucking bird to help you. Grab
my tail!
There you go, buddy. Now have him hold you while you're doing that. Maybe that'll help. Or will it not?
I feel like I've got to like... oh, shit! No! All right, you know what? That coin could go fuck itself.
The hummingbird is like, jeez.
Oh, jeez, noodle. I can't hold you up for very long. Oh, man, boss.
Aw, zoinks. Hey, there's a coin.
Hey,
why don't you
that.
Get that coin? Why don't you get the floor coin?
The floor coin? You mean just change, ground
yes,
change?
Why don't you get I don't pick up ground change unless it's quarters.
Yeah. No pennies.
I don't pick up pennies. I might pick up a dime, but
dragon bird.
Oh, dude, go up.
What the fuck?
Go in it.
What is this?
Go in it.
It's kind of
surely
go
it's
goddamn.
Not like a ooh
snake playground. It's a snake ground.
A snake ground. I like it.
Snake ground. Nope, didn't work. Sorry.
No,
my fault.
You ruined it. It was
did
good.
Any other buttons do anything? No, nothing.
What if he just like explodes?
Got up. We got this one. Nope. Okay.
He's a nice, chill little snake.
Ooh.
Matt Frank owns a snake.
Oh, does he?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Oh, God damn it.
Of course he fucking does.
Yeah.
I'm sure he's just waiting for the moment for it to, like, grow and be a giant kaiju snake or something. Like Manda.
Kaiju snake sounds pretty good.
There is a kaiju snake.
Oh, is there?
Manda.
Oh, okay.
I'm Manda.
I thought you were just talking about yourself. I was like,
I'm not a kaiju snake.
That's your rap name, right? Is kaiju snake? Where you put out the back that ass bub under? Yo, search for kaiju snake on SoundCloud. Hot snake singles coming this summer. Summer snake jams.
Stop
volume
making
two.
Promises. I can't
if we
do
get
it.
One more patron. No,
there's going to be a new level and like everyone that donates
it's $50,000 to produce Amanda's
for
snake.
For $50,000, I will make an entire snake album. I will do 14 songs.
Yep.
And a bonus song.
Uh-huh.
That whoever
what are your stretch goals on the snake rap album?
That's not my stretch goals.
No, 50,000 is just what you need to get the project off the ground.
50,000 for just a SoundCloud album.
Right.
65,000 for a disc album.
Okay.
But I'm only making 10 discs.
Okay.
And then I'm hiding them around Austin.
And I'm going to sell one of them.
Snake area.
Like the Wu-Tang Clan. You sell it to the pharma bro. He's the only one that's got my hot snake rhymes. You guys, you have to ask him if you want those snake rhymes out in the world.
If we hit 100,000,
okay.
Jeff and I do a duet in one of the songs.
Oh, sure. I'll be the hype man. I'll just be like,
what?
I'll be T-Pain.
Snake!
Scales! Slither! Yeah! Snake! Come on, Snake, get up there.
Oh, man.
By the way, developers of this game, if you have $50,000, I don't know how well this game sold, but hey, man, you need a theme song? Just give us one of those Caribbean beats, but
drop me that Caribbean beat.
Give me that Caribbean snake beat. We'll figure something out.
Oh, man.
Yeah. The hot, spitting hot snake rhymes.
Yeah.
Kind of has got a... come on, Snake. He's kind of rocking out. Okay, Snake, what's up here? Do we already come up here?
Feels like the one that you already did.
Oh, God damn it. No.
He barely...
His little oh shit face is really good.
Yeah. It's
Oh, wait. Look, there's the other one that we need.
Yay.
Is there like a...
You got a tightrope walk?
Maybe.
A little bit. The hummingbird's also kind of shimmy shammy.
No. God damn it. I've heard you every time you've said it.
You're not doing it, though. Why aren't you doing it?
I can't figure out how to make it work.
Please. Yeah.
Get up there, Snake. I kind of feel bad sometimes when
there's
I just
a coin.
Like, oh, can I go backwards or am I going to have to like tightrope walk?
Ooh.
Okay.
You just got to do a hard turn.
How many things do I have left?
I think you got all of them.
Oh, no. I got four more.
You're talking about the
blue
bubbles
ones.
Or whatever?
I want the blue ones at least.
Well, wait. There's one in that water.
Which water?
Up in that, if you go up.
Okay.
And then when you hit that little pond or whatever's in there, it's in there.
Oh, there you go.
See, behind that rock.
Oh, right.
The other side of the slide.
Did you see that while we were going up the snake slide?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see, what's through this little door over here?
Oh, there's another one.
I'd love to be able to say that when this video is over that I'm not just going to go back and play Dark Souls, but that's probably what I'm going to end up doing.
What? You're not going to keep playing this?
No. I actually kind of wish that I'd bought this because this came out this week also on the Nintendo Switch. And I kind of wish that I'd bought it on the Switch because this would be the kind of dumb time waster where I could go outside and be like, I'm going to smoke and I'm going to play 12 minutes worth of this Snakey Snake game.
Yeah. And then you learn that there's really like an entire lore and mythology in this world.
It's actually Frog Fractions 3. All right, fuck it. Let's just get out of here. We're already at 30 minutes. We're just about
done. Oh, man.
What took away all the gems and made the darkness?
We don't know yet. It's
I'm down here on the ground.
The story.
What's some other famous snakes?
So we said Snake Plissken.
Jake the Snake Roberts?
Oh, yeah. He's a good
he's pretty
one.
Famous snake. He was razzling back when I used to watch razzling.
Yeah.
You'd take a snake out, put it on a guy, and be like, ha! Ah, and everybody like, no, don't put a snake on a guy!
Yeah. I think the last time he did that was to, it was like throwback wrestling time. And so like everyone was dressed like it was the 80s or like the 70s kind of thing. And it was just like this whole jokey thing. It was kind of fun. But Jake showed up at the very end and beat up a bad guy and he put the snake on him. Mm. And there's this thing when you act like a total fan where they call it marking out because fans are marks.
Okay.
And so the wrestler that had the snake put on him was this fairly young guy at the time. And you could tell he was marking out because he was supposed to be passed out, but he was smiling because Jake the Snake.
Jake the Snake put his snake on me, you guys! You guys!
It was kind of endearing. Like, everyone kind of forgave him because we all kind of got it. Like,
oh, here's a question. Yeah. You might be able to answer this. Okay, so I was watching, when I was watching those snake videos on Imgur, I saw one that was like a wrestling match, but a guy literally had like a green sock that looked like a snake on one hand.
Yeah.
And it was like he was getting messed up, but then like the snake came alive and like saved his ass or something. Do you know what that is?
Yes.
Can you explain that to me?
Oh, man, I can't think of his name. Oh, man.
Uh-oh.
I gotta think of it.
Oh, fuck. Amanda.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Oh, snake.
Hummingbird, help me. Did you not know what you were doing?
Not really.
Santino Marella. That would have bothered the fuck out of me. Santino Marella is a wrestler. He's a comedy wrestler.
Okay.
And he had his special was the fucking snake that I can't think of what the move is called. But he would do like a move where he would literally like form the snake with his hand.
Yeah.
And then he had this sock puppet that...
It's amazing, you guys. You've got to go look this shit up.
Yeah. I don't know what video you saw, but there is a point in one of the wrestling matches where his snake is being controlled by a guy with a flute. And so he's like trying
What in the world?
He's trying to like control it.
What in the goddamn world? What in the fucking hellfire? What in the shit, Amanda?
Because it's a snake. So it was being like...
His fake snake arm.
His fake snake arm was being snake charmed, yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, it's wrestling. What do you want from me?
Yeah, well, that's true.
But it's fun. I mean, there's... okay. Now, this one, you can look up on YouTube. It's called The Most Illegal Wrestling Move Ever.
Uh-huh.
I believe that was done by a wrestler from Chikara. I want to say his name was King Cobra.
Okay.
I'm going to look it up.
The band King Cobra. That's another good snake.
It's King Cobra.
Iron Eagle.
He does a thing where he, like, hypnotizes you.
Uh-huh. Like with snake powers?
Yeah. And he, how do you spell Chikara? Oh, no. There you go. Or maybe it's Ophidian. I don't know. There's several different snakes.
There's a lot of snake wrestlers out
there. There's a lot, yeah. But anyway, he does a thing where he does a move and it, like, hypnotizes the wrestler that he's fighting against, or the two wrestlers. I think it's like a tag match.
Uh-huh.
And then they do it to the audience.
Uh-huh.
And they do it to the backstage.
Uh-huh.
And so everyone's supposed to be hypnotized.
Yeah.
And then they made the wrestlers dance. And then everyone started dancing, and the entire backstage roster comes out and starts dancing because they're all hypnotized.
Uh-huh.
It's the most illegal. The reason why the video is called that.
Oh, fuck.
Oh,
fuck.
Oh, you're fucked.
Fuck!
Maybe
man, I was really close.
Maybe if you hit L2 and had a tighter grip.
No, I was doing it. I was trying to figure out how that worked.
And you thought doing it over a bottomless pit was the time to do
it? No, that's a perfect time. There's stakes. There's snakes.
God, Jesus.
If you know what I'm saying.
But the reason why it's called the most illegal move is because the guy that's doing the commentating actually is like flipping his shit over it, and he's like, this could possibly be the most illegal move in wrestling. And it's just like everyone's dancing. Like it's not.
Like nobody's getting hurt.
Yeah, like nothing bad's actually happening. But it's just really funny.
Oh, shit. Nope, 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 nope.
Hummingbird, hummingbird, please. Nope, nope, hummingbird.
Nope. I'm holding on.
Is it just coiling that?
Well, it like it makes it so that the priority is on holding instead of on Slytherin.
That's another one, Slytherin.
Yeah, yeah, Severus Snake or Voldemort. He who shall not be snaked. Whoa. No, I need to get around this thing. That's what I need. Oh shit. Up, snake, up, noodle, what are you doing here? Come on, noodle, come on, buddy, we're good. Okay, hold on, you hold on tight. All we gotta do is get this one thing.
You hold on tight, ass in.
Oh shit, go back up your own tail, No! All right, I think that's about all the snake and I got in me here.
Oh, man.
Folks, hey, if you're watching this on YouTube, hit the like and subscribe button. If you'd like to see this video a day earlier, these videos a day earlier, you guys had a Rage Select, or I don't know, keep watching on YouTube, but I'm just going to fucking shut down Rage Select. I told you that last week. I went on our YouTube page. It's like only a quarter of the people who watch our videos are watching them on the website. It's kind of like, man, I got to pay for that website. I mean, I'm not salty. I'm just like, it would be really a lot easier for me if I was just posting YouTube videos on Facebook.
Yeah.
But I don't know what the implications are if we would, like, lose fans or whatever. But anyway, enough of that. If you would like to buy a thing from us on Amazon, if you'd like to buy anything off of Amazon, do us a favor and do it through us. Mention some Amazon links down below. I don't know if they'll be on this one, but they should be on some of our videos. If not this one, then probably Monday, Tuesday videos. Maybe. I don't know. Can never tell what's actually going to be sold on Amazon and what's not.
If you would like to buy a snake or snake-like products.
Yes. Snake or snake accessories.
Perhaps a Santino Marella commemorative sock puppet. Snake puppet.
Do they sell those on Amazon?
Probably.
Yep. What don't they sell on Amazon?
This game.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Do us a favor and find one of the links on the website. Click on that. And as long as you start by clicking on that link, we will get a little piece of whatever it is that you buy. If you would like to help us out even more, Rage Select is 100% funded through the patrons. Patreon.com/RageSelect. You basically kick us some bucks. In return, we'll kick you some bonus videos that nobody else gets to see. Including Amanda and I do videos all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think what do we have last week? Well, Hollow Knight and a little more everything.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. We played all the everything.
I did a count last week.
You can also get the most amazing email that I ever saw from for patrons.
I hit the enter button by accident. It just said, and then just links.
Just an email that said, to all the patrons.
Yep.
It was the greatest moment.
Like, it was the most.
John and I were having lunch, and I'm like, why is Jeff just yelling at us?
Snake! Yeah. And at the rate that we're going, I just wanted to, like, let everybody know. I want to, like, shout out all of our patrons. I actually feel like I want to go some point and make a video and just say everybody's name in one video. Just we'll make a little story for every patron that there is.
Nice.
There's, like, 400, so it might take a few videos. That's actually, like, 450, I believe, at this point, or even
nice,
more
guys.
Than that. But if you guys keep up this same pace of patronage that you've had for the last month, we'll be able to, like, just do all kinds of great stuff. We will never have to worry about, or we'll be able to, within reason, do things like, I don't know, like I could go to like a con or something, I don't know, or like maybe fly somewhere and do like a, the, I don't know, like a crossover.
Yeah,
but like, it would,
like find some people from out of town and do some crossover videos. That would be so fun.
It would be something where I wouldn't have to worry as much about cash, whereas right now I just have to worry about cash. So good on you guys is what I'm saying. And if you'd like to help us stick around and do more stuff, Patreon is the place to do so.
Yeah.
Patreon.com/RageLight. With that, we're gonna snake on out of here. We're gonna slither on out of here. We have a new video tomorrow. I forgot what's coming out next week, but it's gonna be great. We'll see you then, everybody. Amanda.
What?
Amanda, I'm a snake now.
You're not a snake, Jeff.
Amanda, I'm a snake.
You're not a snake. You're holding a toy up to the camera.
No, I'm not. That's not my hand. I'm not a. I'm a snake now.
Nope. Mm-mm.